Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi
warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh.
wabarakatuh. Let's begin with Ummul Kitab Al-Fatihah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, we have only 1 hour. Hopefully 15 minutes lah. But actually, the hadiths there are so many diagnosis or subject or topic to be covered. Nah, okay. So let's start with this slide. Actually, this one for year two lecture. Yeah. So I just repeat, this is anatomy, no need to explain. Okay, please bear in your mind that the incidence of congenital hadices is remains high, yeah, around 1 in 100 cases, yeah, 8 to 10 per 1,000 lah, but yeah, so around 1% of the newborn babies will have hadices. Those are the variety of the diseases. So many kan. Tapi we will cover yang few common, and then of course for the short term for your final pro preparation, and then hopefully for your husbandship lah, for common diseases that you might handle later. Okay, the pressure is like this. Highest of course left ventricle, the lowest will be right atrium. Okay, it is very clear that most common will be acinotic, yeah, around 70% compared to young cyanotic one. The concept will be left to right for acinotic and right to left for cyanotic. Normal, just know if normal pressure will be left heart pressure will be higher left ventricle and left atrium, but in certain situation, right heart pressure will be higher, so right to left shunt will come out in cyanotic heart disease. Why? Because there are some complex situation, so that's why. In cyanotic, usually it will be complex cyanotic heart disease. Okay, we start for acinotic. You just divide whether it is increased pulmonary blood flow or obstruction. Yeah, increased pulmonary blood flow, you can see, you can X-ray will help you. Yeah? There will be plethoric lung. Paru dia nampak putih-putih sikit compared to the normal lung X-ray. Those are the types. Why it will be plethoric? Yeah, because of course left to right shunt, more blood volume, hemodynamic goes more to the pulmonary circulation, so it will be plethoric lung. Whereas some other condition, obstructive outflow, it can be PS, it will be oligemic lung, but if aortic and coarctation of aorta, the lung will not affected, yeah, lung circulation. Okay, I will be a little bit fast, yeah, because you should be understand those diseases, yeah. The VST is here. Okay, this you can read by yourself, yeah, in the textbook, in the library. Okay, the types can be outlet. Outlet means near the aorta and pulmonary artery. PM, perimembranous, most common. And then inlet is near the tricuspid and mitral valve. And then the down there is muscular VST. Okay. We usually categorize yeah, whether the defect is small, moderate, or large. It depends on the size, usually less than 3 millimeter, we call it small. And then we can expect it close spontaneously. Muscular usually sooner to be closed. 90% by 6 years old. So usually common management for small TST is expectation. We expect we wait until close until 6 year old patient. If until 6 years do not close, usually memang there is 10% possibility will be closed later. But we see lah, sometimes we may close with intervention, yeah. Intracatheter procedure or operative procedure. For moderate, the risk of congenital heart failure, congestive heart failure is there, or pulmonary hypertension. So we should monitor closely, maybe 3 monthly. If the heart failure develop, we must treat the heart failure and of course close immediately, no need to wait until 6 years old. Another common complication is of course in children, don't forget, is growth failure, yeah, FTT. If patient looks tiny, small, malnourished, so we should do close VSD closure earlier, yeah, as well as other heart diseases, yeah, more or less the same lah. Earlier closure, so usually after closure will have adequate growth. This one, yeah. Last VSD, last VSD usually we don't wait. Kalau tadi yang small, we wait until 6 years. Moderate, same, we still expect unless develop heart failure or FTT. But last VSD usually early in infancy will develop FTT or heart failure as well. By age 3 or 6 months, we should close earlier than that. Nah. Okay. What's the murmur? You should be always remember pansexual murmur on lower left anal edge. Usually grade 3, grade 4. This is the theory how you interpret the murmur. No need to explain now. Already year 5, nah, final year. Okay, next is ASD. The defect is there. Of course, again, left to right side. It is most commonly asymptomatic. Why? Because the flow is not as many as VSD, because pressure is left atrium only around 15-20 millimeter mercury, so there will be slow shunt. Even the murmur usually sometimes is not really heard. Yeah, the murmur from the left to right shunt is not really heard. But what we can hear is the systolic murmur, usually ejection systolic in the pulmonary area. Don't ask me why. So I already explained many times, usually during bedside teaching, and then you can read again in textbook, due to excessive blood flow from left to right shunt goes to the right atrium, right ventricle, and then turbulence in the pulmonary valve area. And then will be wide and fixed speed of second heart sound, delay of pulmonary valve closure, compare the aortic valve closure. Okay, the location will be near the ostium secundum or primum or sinus venosus. Most common is ostium secundum. This is a transcatheter device. Yeah. No need to do surgical cardiothoracic surgery. Just insert catheter through the femoral vein and then IVC, and then deploy the device here. Ya masuk tuh ya macam still some macam catheter ya, but after reach the location, we can deploy macam umbrella. If you can imagine umbrella, masuk tuh kan masuk macam ni, then we can apa namanya, inflate the umbrella. Nah, next is PDA, still the same dari dulu pun sampai maybe until apa adjustment day, still same lah. And the PDA will be continuous murmur. Yeah, so many in preterm baby because normally a preterm baby still open ductus. Usually the ductus will close in term baby even not at birth pun after few days. We usually wait 1-3 until 5 days. But preterm usually still open. Okay. This is the PDA location again left to right shunt. This is the continuous or the machinery murmur there on the left subclavian. In preterm babies, when the PDA, when the ductus is persistent, we may start conservative management. We may start the medication to close with ibuprofen and paracetamol. How it works? Because this is anti-inflammatory drugs, it will apa namanya dia stop the prostaglandin, so the vessel will be vasoconstricted. The effect of the prostaglandin in the ductus will be vasodilatation. So that's why in other cases nanti later in critical congenital heart disease that we need PDA, we will open the PDA with prostaglandin, ya, prostin. Prostaglandin will dilate the ductus, whereas this drug will reduce the prostaglandin and then the ductus will be constricted and then close. Yeah. Okay, that's a simple explanation. Next is FASD. Don't forget it is in commonly in Down syndrome, but currently pun usually my patient in the clinics Down syndrome patient not only FASD, ya, there are cases of ASD and PDA as well as FASD, ya, usually asymptomatic. Okay, this FASD will problem in the both interventricular and interatrial septum. Okay. How about the obstructive lesion? Yeah, the obstruction will be on the right RVOT, yeah, right ventricular outflow tract obstruction (PS) or LVOT. Yeah, the coarctation is also LVOT. Okay, narrowing PS. If it is simple PS, still asynotic, so the management will be balloon angioplasty. Again, transcatheter, and then inflate the balloon on the pulmonary valve. Okay, what is it? Bilang pula, tutup atas nih. Yeah. Only PA with VST, yeah. No. The total obstruction from the right ventricle, so the blood will need other defect. Now we need PST, for example, here will be right to left shunt. This condition, yeah, we call it PA with VST. If PS with VST, usually will form a tetralogy of Fallot. So PS and then VST right to left shunt, so will be right overriding aorta and then develop also right ventricular hypertrophy. If PA, ya kita tak boleh sebut TOF because TOF should be PS. Kalau atresia, ya still we mention as PA with VST. This is total obstruction, ya, yeah, will cyanosis. Actually, this PN with VST is not in acyanotic group, yeah, will be in cyanotic group. Aortic stenosis, yeah, similar. We do balloon angioplasty, balloon falboplasty or angioplasty juga boleh, mana-mana to dilate the valve. Okay. It is coarctation. You may see here aorta, this ascending aorta and then aortic arch will be three branches. First to the right subclavian, right arm, and then the second will be common carotid artery, and then third branch will be left arm. So most common will be after third branch. So it will have radiofemoral delay and upper limb BP higher than lower limb. But sometimes it come, the coarctation is before the third branch. So you may find radioradial delay and right arm BP higher than left arm BP. All right, what is it? Still coarctation. Okay. Okay, now goes to the cyanotic. I think I will go to the next presentation in a minute. I will switch to this slide. This is on a cyanotic part lesion. Okay, you still able to see my slide, is it?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, now cyanosis only able to detect it if usually actually SpO2 less than 90, but by our eyes too usually need less than 85 or even less than 80 baru nampak biru. Okay. How do we distinguish whether the cyanosis is due to the cyanotic heart disease or maybe other problem, especially lung? Kan? So you do an oxygen test. Yeah, give 100% oxygen for around not more than 5 minutes lah, 3 minutes sometimes, yeah, 1 to 2 minutes lah, if possible. Because if it is cyanotic heart disease, maybe it is critical congenital heart disease that need PDA. If you give oxygen too long, the PDA will close due to the vasoconstriction. So you give 100% oxygen. So you see, if the SpO2 increase to above 90-95, yeah, it is not heart disease, not cyanotic. Yeah. Maybe still heart disease there, yang is cyanotic. Usually, yeah, it's common. Patient baby with congenital pneumonia, apalagi with preterm baby with RDS. So lung problem is so many, yeah. So many lung problem in the babies. So the heart disease is actually rare. The 1% is the congenital heart disease, usually asynotic kan, yang cyanotic tadi only 20% of them. So if SpO2 increase, it is not heart. If it is cyanotic congenital heart disease, the SpO2 usually will remain below 90, and then if you take ABG, arterial blood gas, so you see PO2 nih. PO2 in cardiac disease will never above 100 in complex cyanotic. Okay. You also need to distinguish in neonatal, in newborn babies. If the bluish is only on the face, it is not really central cyanosis, ya. Yang central cyanosis yang tadi just now. Despite ini tak nampak pun. Oh sorry, this is acrocyanosis. It is only peripheral cyanosis. Of course, due to inadequate oxygenation. Yeah, we just wait lah until a few minutes until SpO2 above 95, dia baru akan hilang, akan pink semua. This is not heart disease. This one also not heart disease, yeah, because it is only on the face due to cut around neck tadi, yeah. Okay, if it is cyanotic heart disease, remember due to chronic hypoxia will develop clubbing, but not in newborn, yeah, after a few months usually. Okay, remember always 5 days. Kalau you nak tambah lagi, ya ini ada HLHS, ada tadi PA with VSD usually, or critical PS, and then DORV, then many more. Ada apa, double inlet left ventricle pun ada, and then apa, right isomerism, left isomerism, all those complex apa heart diseases usually cyanotic. Okay, how do you divide? Again, X-ray will help you with evaluate the lung. If it is increased pulmonary blood flow with left ventricular hypertrophy, usually can defect like TGA with VSD, single ventricle, truncus arteriosus. If the apa namanya, the hypertrophy is on the right, despite X-ray, yeah, you need also ECG. Yeah, you get left or right ventricle hypertrophy by ECG. If by X-ray, you only able to recognize cardiomegaly. So it is a common procedure, yeah, standard SOP in heart disease. Before you ask the cardiologist to do echo, please do initial investigation, simple X-ray and ECG. It is common, MOs pun malas nak buat apa X-ray and ECG, terus minta je cardiologist buat echo. So please don't do that, because X-ray and ECG will help us to diagnose, because sometimes echo is not, it's not easy, especially in complex. Kalau in simple, ya okay lah, we can just find the defect. In complex, sometimes we have difficulty to determine the diagnosis. So with X-ray, ECG, we can configure what are the possibility. If right ventricle hypertrophy, ya TGA, intact septum usually. HLHS, so ini contoh how we categorize. If decreased pulmonary blood flow, maknanya the pulmonary stenosis is there. Yeah. This one TGA with PS or with PA. And lagi kalau yang left ventricle ini tricuspid atresia, another possibility not PS tapi tricuspid atresia. POF of course, niat. Remember TOF, ya, yeah? Most common cyanotic heart disease, it will be oligemic lung, reduced pulmonary blood flow with right ventricular hypertrophy. Ada lagi Epstein anomaly. Epstein anomaly is very obvious, if you do echo akan nampak sangat, very large right atrium due to the weakness of the tricuspid tricuspid valve, yeah? And then will be small right ventricle. Okay, this what is important in the cyanotic congenital heart disease, yeah, complex cyanotic heart disease, whether it is drug dependent or not, ya. Yeah. Drug dependent pun you, because drug dependent it will be critical, ya. Yeah. The cyanotic heart disease that is depend to the drug, it we call it critical congenital heart disease. Why critical? Because if the drug close, patient die. Yeah, it is not us who determine the life or death, ya. Yeah. But yeah, it is sunatullah lah kalau doctors close, patient die. Yeah, we may expect that. Yeah. Okay, if it can be systemic circulation to that depend to the duct, it also can be pulmonary circulation to that depend to the duct. Most common actually the pulmonary circulation lah, but also there are situation of systemic circulation that depend on the PDA. For example, HL, HS, so no left ventricle, hypoplastic left ventricle, maybe no function from left ventricle. So systemic circulation will rely on the PDA to receive blood, to receive oxygenation as well. Critical aortic stenosis, ada shown compact variant, nanti you merit by yourself. Saya pun tak pernah jumpa yang itu. Koa yang critical ya. Ada koa, kalau koa only mild koa is okay, patient will survive. Tapi critical or interrupted ya, interrupted means ya aorta is not patent. So only receive blood, systemic circulation only receive blood from the PDA. Okay, and then more common actually ya TOF kan. TOF with PA, tadi PA actually bukan TOF kan, kita sebut PA with VST. PA with intact septum ya, no VST. Ya, all name need PDA. So jadi PA with PDA actually bukan TOF. Because in this situation, because PA there will be no apa namanya in PA intact septum ya, no VST, no right of riding aorta. The RVH is there lah, but the PS pun tak ada. Okay, this one ya, PA intact septum, similar situation. Possibilities banyak. Actually the same similar situation, but sometimes atresia, sometimes stenosis, sometimes with VST, sometimes intact septum, but configuration ya around there lah. Patient will be blue itu aja. Kalau Yuna senang, will be cyanotic. Okay, those. Alright. So, how do you recognize newborn baby? Yeah, of course cyanosis. But most likely kan tadi yang apa namanya pulmonary circulation yang depend to the duct. In this situation, baby usually will stable. Even the cyanosis, baby will not distress. Usually limited sign of respiratory distress. Different with lung problem, if RDS, pneumonia, apalagi asphyxia, the baby will have severe distress that you need to intubate and ventilate. In this situation, baby still okay ya. Even though biru, dia okay ya. Napas biasa aja, tidur biasa. So in this situation, yang penting your decision ya. Of course, if possible, you do echo dulu, and then start prostin dari. You of course call the cardiologist to send the baby. Or maybe call the cardiologist if in suspect ya, send kalau in FDA ya to call Dr. Ami ya. Oke. But sometimes kalau yang what we call it systemic circulation yang depend to the duct, contoh HL HS tadi, hypoplastic left ventricle, so there will be no adequate apa namanya? Left systemic circulation, cardiac output, inadequate cardiac output, the patient will have hypotension, yeah, shock. Okay, sorry. Yang penuh, saya tak nampak yang atas ini karena tertutup di Zoom punya. Tidak. Okay, this is PDA tadi ya. The doctors kan, how we keep the PDA open. This is investigation. Kalau koa ya, check the apa for limbs BP. Oh ya, yeah. the simple procedure to check the critical congenital heart disease is preductal and postductal SpO2. So preductal means right arm, yeah, right thumb or palmnya. Postductal can be left, tapi better you go to the foot. If the discrepancy is more than 3%, of course the you expect lower SpO2 in lower limb compared to the right right arm. If you put preductal left boleh, tapi sometimes kan left itu bukan preductal juga, because tadi ductus not always after third branch, but can be before third branch. Alright, nah, ini tadi hyperoxia test, oksigen 100% oksigen ya. Hyperoxia you can try, but not more than, kalau sini boleh 10 minutes lah in teori, tapi usually we don't do lah. In this case, usually we already know this is critical congenital, tak payah bagi oksigen, because risk of PDA close. Yeah, this is the PGA1, the prostaglandin. Next is TOF, the most common. No need to explain, you must know. Apa lagi ini? Severity depend on the PS, degree of the RVOT. Okay, most common. This is the configuration, the boot shape, heart. This is echo by parasternal long axis, right ventricle in the top, left ventricle in down there. So this is the VST. And then aorta not 100% come from the left ventricle, tapi around 25 to 50% come from the right ventricle. Okay. The problem in TOF will usually rarely develop heart failure, because there is pulmonary stenosis, obstruction for the pulmonary circulation. So what will happen if there is stenosis, in increased oxygen demand, usually patient menangis, crying, baby crying, or in certain infection, yeah, demam, will develop sudden deepening of stenosis that we call it TED spell or hypercyanotic spell or cyanotic spell, mana-mana lah. Okay, what we can do ini saja, lower SVR, increase resistance. What happened ini, because increase resistance will increase the right to left shunt, and then develop tachypnea. Okay, treatment what we can do is knee chest position. So we expect sudden reduce of the venous return, supaya reduce the congestion of the pulmonary section, and then give morphine to dilate, to relax the patient, and then dilate the pulmonary artery. Bicap, of course, because patient usually will develop metabolic acidosis. Yang ini phenylephrine we don't give actually. And then propanolol if for the spell we give IV. But for the prevention, usually patient with TOF, if highly developed spell, we give oral propranolol daily. Beta blocker to reduce heart rate, supaya dia reduce pressure juga on the pulmonary stenosis. Treatment can be primary repair terus, betulkan terus, tapi not that easy. The picture is very easy. Close the VST, dilate the pulmonary artery. Ini simple kan? If simple or mild TOF boleh, tapi most of the cases with that severe, usually we need PT shunt first. Shunt from right subclavian to the right pulmonary artery. So we'll have left to right shunt here. So there will be adequate circulation to the pulmonary to the lung, yang because this is stenosis here, stenosis in the pulmonary valve. So we give shunt from the artery to the systemic artery here to the pulmonary artery. Okay. Okay, then TGA already 236. We have only 20 minutes left. Yeah? TGA is transposition. Of course, baby also blue. Depend if there is TGA in order baby to survive. Yeah, need other defect. Need complex. Sometimes ada ESD here. Sometimes ada VSD. Another situation is TGA intact septum, no ESD, no VSD. So it will be duct dependent lesion. TGA intact septum is critical, another critical congenital heart disease. We must give prostin first to maintain the PDA, keep PDA open, and then later usually will do PDA stenting, give a ring to the PDA supaya tak tutup. And then another emergency procedure, despite give prostin, cardiologist can do balloon atrial septostomy. So make artificial AST. Usually kan in newborn baby, masa baru lahir, in the first few hours, PDA kan still open with the prostin. And then the foramen ovale pun still not anatomically closed. There is still open macam the door, if you remember when I explained about the foramen ovale. In intrauterine, there will be right to left shunt, kan? So the foramen ovale can open, can give blood from the right atrium to left atrium. But after birth, kan, the left atrium pressure will be higher, so it should be closed. But can still functional only. In TGA intact septum, we may try to open the foramen ovale. Again, letak the intracatheter, put the balloon, and then inflate. So we'll make artificial AST supaya open, and then we'll have blood flow. Usually, yeah, depend on the pressure. Usually, will be left to right shunt lah. So, jadilah PDA, TGA itu jadi kurang biru. Kalau yang TGA before the septostomy, dia akan very blue. Only rely on the PDA, but after septostomy, dia akan ada left to right shunt from the atrium as well as the PDA. Jadi, usually less blue. If you go to NICU or today patient baby already depart to IGN, yesterday still here. Okay, this is how you, what is it, so this is accept kan? Oh bukan, this is another situation. Oh, still TGA kan? Okay. The TGA actually accept kan? When you see in the echo, we parallel PA and aorta, not crisscross, usually normal will be cross. Ya? Aorta in the posterior, pulmonary artery in the anterior, PA from right ventricle goes to the left sikit, aorta from the left ventricle goes to the right sikit, and then ascending, and then left aortic arch. Nah, itu yang normal, yang this TGA ya transpose. Long axis macam ini paralel, kalau short axis jadi dua two round shape arteries. Okay, TAPVD or TAPVL. Now you see that pulmonary vein normally will come to left atrium. There are two from left lung and then two from right lung. Right pulmonary vein and left pulmonary vein. But sometimes it come to the supracardia, to the SVC, sometimes goes to the SVC, sometimes goes to the red atrium, ni sinus venosus kalau tak silap. Nanti anda kat belakang. Nah, yang intrakardia kan, goes to the coronary sinus. So not goes to left atrium, tapi goes to the right atrium. Yang supracardia goes to the SVC. Yang infrakardia goes to the IVC. So apa jadi? Ya, of course, baby will cyanose because no adequate systemic circulation, no adequate oxygen. Sometimes next, yeah. So what you can see in the X-ray will be snowman like, yeah. Dia akan figure of eight, dia akan besar di ventricle, both cardiomegaly, and then besar lagi ke atas. And snowman. Alright. Okay, again, if it is intact septum, so no adequate systemic circulation, we must give prostin BGA1 to keep PDA open. It is critical. Another critical is tricuspid atresia. So you can imagine no blood flow from right atrium to right ventricle. So from where the lung circulation get the body of us from PDA. Okay, this is another palliative procedure. Yeah, kalau TOF usually we do a BT shunt, but other complex analytics sometimes we do Glenn and Fontan shunt. Glenn shunt to from SVC connect to PA. Kalau Fontan IVC to the PA. Okay, next is truncus arteriosus, also cyanosis, but this is usually not critical. Because ya truncus arteriosus ya of course because only one what we call it common arteries aorta and pulmonary artery jadi satu usually will have large VSD here usually sampai single ventricle but in case intact septum it will be DILV for example double inlet left ventricle so both aorta and pulmonary artery from left ventricle contohnya DILV is critical. Kalau truncus arteriosus because ada VSD, large VSD is not critical. Okay, dah ini soal yang saya notik tadi ada berapa belum acquired. We have only 10 minutes. Ini pun tadi Aisyah potong banyak stempel. Okay, goes to the last yang acquired. Acquired, ya, of course. Remember yang awal, yang the mainstay, ya, remember the rheumatic heart disease, ya. But also Kawasaki. Most common actually rheumatic heart disease, ya. Chronic rheumatic after rheumatic liver. Of course Kawasaki and IE you need to know and myocarditis. Kawasaki is not the motor but Prof. Tomisakui just died 2021 I see. Eh bukan before COVID lah. 2019 for example. If I'm not mistaken ya. Yang ini 2012 still alive Prof. Kawasaki. So remember it is apa unknown etiology, but the concept is vasculitis, usually small and medium vessel vasculitis. It hyper apa sensitivity reaction due to the infection, dia jadi hypersensitive, so akan induce small and medium vessel vasculitis. So will develop the features of Kawasaki. Yang medium vessel, be aware about the coronary artery vasculitis. So the features, ini ya, vasculitis on the eyes will develop conjunctivitis, non-purulent, bilateral. On the mucus, you can see strawberry tongue. Boleh juga apa injected throat. On the hands and feet, jadi edema and edema. And then on the skin, jadi maculopapular rash, polymorph usually. And then on the lymph node, jadi cervical lymphadenopathy, usually unilateral. That's the feature. Okay. Less than 5 years, it common ya yeah, in infant ya sampai 5 tahun. After 5 years ya still possible but rare. So you cari, kalau you cari Kawasaki disease ya budak kecil ya, under 5. The younger the age, usually the higher risk to develop Kawasaki. And then of course genetic tadi ya, don't forget ya apa namanya is punya ya itulah turunan apa namanya Indo-China ya, dari China, Jepun, turun bawah-bawah Vietnam tuh banyak. So Jepun paling banyak lah, and then Vietnam still banyak lagi. Saya so kalau you nak research tuh Thailand, I think not that many because Thailand is dia different risk. Malaysia dan Indonesia tuh masih dapat lah apa gen from the Jepun and Indochina tuh. Okay, can be my heart, can be cream. So you boleh pakai mana-mana. Okay, this is the complete features. Ada banyak lagi features that you may see if in case incomplete Kawasaki kan. Kawasaki you need at least 4 out of 5. Tapi in case incomplete only 2 or 3, cari other features. Maybe thrombocytosis, maybe sterile pyuria, maybe ada hydrophobic gallbladder, ada aseptic meningitis. And this is yang also simple but important, check the BCG scar. Kalau indurated dia merah, so usually Kawasaki yang ada. This is the picture. Ada acute phase, subacute, and apa convalescent. Acute phase the first 10 days it is gold standard to start IVIG, but not too early because early might be in the first 3 days there are so many DDX, maybe apa tadi ya, maybe Escherichia fever, maybe other bacterial infection, and so on and so forth, maybe viral exantem. So don't too early give FAG, nanti jadi wasting resources. FAG sekarang dah habis kata, only in Melaka yang last week ada, in mana-mana tempat tak ada. Kalau dah but, not too early but not late also, kalau dah past the acute phase in the subacute already febrile, yeah, it is late, already develop coronary artery aneurysm. What is the purpose to give FAG is to stop the progressivity of the disease, to prevent coronary artery aneurysm in the acute phase, but usually after in the day 5 up to day 10 lah the golden period to give FAG. Kalau day usually tak demam dah lambat dah, dah dilated artery dah. Nah subacute dah macam ni dah apa nama descommission. Sampai yang convalescent jadi apa nih? Pu apa namanya? Bios line ya. This is the features how you Kawasaki ECG also need to be done, don't forget. Of course echo to determine the coronary artery size. Okay, this one apa nih tadi? Nanti you tak apalah this one for dilated left coronary artery in normal. yang right macam ni, features normal, aneurysm ni besar ni. Usually yang the last few cases actually not Kawasaki tapi Kawasaki leg. It is MIC ya, yeah. After COVID develop MIC Kawasaki leg illness. We got three cases lah in SASMEC the past few months ni. Yang dua macam ni, yang satu normal. Oke, okay. Incomplete. Nah, unit echo, unit tadi other features, elevated CRP, ESR, thrombocytosis to make sure all this most likely Kawasaki, because Kawasaki you don't have confirmatory diagnosis, investigation tak ada. By clinical only and some criteria to decide whether it is Kawasaki or not, to give FAG or not. But if already 4 out of 5 or all features of Kawasaki is there, you simply start or give IVIG. Pitfall apa nih? Ini, features is not in same time. Ya. Jangan cari 5-5 masa you examine. This one. History taking. Sometimes now come at day 5. You tanya dua hari lepas atau masa awal sakit ada mata merah ketak. So it is the key to determine or establish diagnosis of Kawasaki. Not all the features in same time. Yeah. Nah, usually kalau less than one year, higher Kawasaki tapi usually incomplete. Nah, susah nak get all the features tuh kalau in infant. Kalau older usually 3 years. Hari itu umur 3-4 tahun kan, all 5 years saya very of lah, dari nampak dari jauh oh, this is Kawasaki, tak payah history taking pun. Okay, this is a detail of treatment, nanti you baca sendiri, cari sendiri in again in the references. This is what we to develop, ya. If develop aneurysm, if small maybe can resolve, tapi moderate tak tahu need longer period. But giant aneurysm will develop thrombosis, stenosis, and can develop myocardial infarct macam adult. Or sometimes kalau very weak punya coronary artery dia rupture. Ya, sudden death lah kalau rupture. Oke, ini hai. Yang next, ini next apa namanya? Class at 3 is in same room or different room? Halo. Anybody? Halo.
Different.
Different ya. Oke lah, I just stop ya kok. Just go through lah, no need to explain, tapi just go through the rheumatic fever, chronic rheumatic, the apa namanya, Jones criteria, how do you establish diagnosis, jangan lupa Jones criteria, and then the IE is due criteria, okay. Myocarditis, ya, check the apa namanya, cardiac biomarker. It's common ya, myocarditis in children, apalagi post COVID. Don't only cari apa blame COVID vaksin ya. Memang ada possibility myocarditis after vaksin, tapi only 2 out of 1 million yang develop myocarditis after COVID ya, dia berapa peratus saya pun tak ingat. The number is very large. Okay, so yang little bit fast about the tadi yang rheumatic heart disease, because it is common kan, usually in final pro tuh ramai aja rheumatic heart disease kan. Kalau myocarditis ya jarang lah for final pro kan, because ill baby or ill patient. IE itu also ill patient, but rheumatic heart disease biasanya can develop chronic and then we can invite for exam. Don't forget, remember John usually 2 major or 1 major plus 2 minor with evidence of post-tetokokal infection, positive ASOT, and or positive culture to swab. Yeah. Usually always from the tonsil, yeah. Yang kardionya apa namanya type. Tapi kalau yang from the skin. Yang glomerulonephritis (AGN) can get from the skin or from the throat. So yang kalau throat infection, staphylococcal can develop rheumatic fever, can develop AGN. But kalau skin infection, staphylococcal only develop AGN. Yeah. Okay, so that's in the newly diagnosed. You need to establish that. But in case recurrent or relapse of rheumatic fever, case itu udah rheumatic disease, chronic, but sometimes develop relapse kan. So no need to fulfill two major or one major plus two minor. Just patient fever jo, in leukocytosis jo, we restart treatment of rheumatic fever. Another important is if you find chorea is no need to go with Jones criteria. No need to go, you know, two major or one major plus two minor to determine diagnosis of rheumatic fever. In chorea only one single major, but of course with evidence. Ya, bukan chorea saja. Chorea saja, maybe it is not rheumatic fever. Maybe it was other intracranial problem lah kan, neurologic problem. But chorea with evidence of staphylococcal infection, ada ASOT positif or positive culture, you start treatment of rheumatic fever. Usually chorea in female patient. And then common rheumatic disease will be in the systemic, either mitral or aortic valve yang involved, will be regurgitation. Dah, no room for QA session. Good luck for your exam and block final pro, and then your future career insyaallah. So thank you all. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Thank you, Dr.
Thank you, Dr.
Yeah, Dr.